What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome to another episode of GoGTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Hope you're doing well. This is the national preview show, Ivan. Are you ready?
Oh my goodness. I am so excited, Rob. This is literally my second favorite show of the entire year. My favorite show of the year is our national recap show that we get to do after the national. And you want to know what my least favorite show of the year is, Rob?
Sure. What's that?
Well, it's the national. Because of the fact that during the national, I actually have to wear pants, unlike the other 50 shows a year that we do.
Don't you? It reminds me of that Simpson episode. Don't you hate pants?
Exactly. No, actually, I don't mind putting on pants to see all of you and go to the national and have a lot of fun. Learn more and more about card collecting than I ever do from the incredible guests and the lineup and all the events. And we're going to talk about all of that tonight.
So, oh my gosh. We have a jam-packed show tonight. We don't have time to screw around. And I'm telling you guys at home, grab your water, grab a snack. There will be built-in opportunities for you to take a quick break, although we don't want you to miss anything. Not only is it the national preview show, but we have other hobby happenings going on, so we got to talk about that. James had the opportunity to go to San Diego Comic-Con this weekend, and we put him to Comic-Con. Work, and he delivered a bunch of content that we had to break up into three video segments throughout the show tonight. Plus, Top sent me a 10-pound package, so we've got like four box breaks tonight. And then we've got Hot in the Shop and, yeah, the big national preview. So, but first and foremost, Ivan, we got the poll. And that poll is, if you could only stop at one manufacturer booth at the national, whose would it be?
Oh, and you're going to make me choose,
if it's other, please reply. So we went with the big four, Panini, Topps, Upper Deck, and Leaf. 186 of you weighing in, and Topps in the lead at 41%. Panini and Upper Deck neck and neck, 28 and 27% respectively. Leaf at 4%, and then our other replies, a couple people for Cryptozoic.
Yeah, and that, well, Melanie Pauls knows exactly how that goes down.
Yeah, we'll explain that in the preview show for sure. Yeah, for sure.
But real quick, so just to explain about that a little bit. So remember, we said the Twitter poll. I noticed like E Dixon 10 just said in Twitch, "What's up? First time here." Well, E Dixon, if you're watching on Twitch, but you want to participate in the giveaways we're going to do tonight, because we've still got plenty of giveaways, even though we've got so much information to share. We do all of our giveaways through Twitter. So make sure you also take a second to follow GoGTS Live on Twitter, twitter.com/GoGTSLive. Take 2 seconds to vote in that poll that's pinned to the top of the page there. And then also retweet the Periscope tweet with the show, because that'll probably get you entered to win something a little bit later. So just be reminded of that, all of you viewers across Facebook, YouTube, live stream, Twitch, Twitch Prime. Thank you, Ryan SC07, for subscribing on Twitch Prime. That's much appreciated. And yeah. Which manufacturer would you go to if you had just one, Rob, based on your experience visiting the national and with the various booths that they have?
I'm not answering this question. I didn't even vote in
it. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, really? I did.
I don't want to know your answer.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it was just from an interactivity standpoint. There was one that I would prefer more than the others. If
that's fine.
To.
That's fine. Okay. Yeah, we're Switzerland to some degree. So when it comes to things like that, I don't want to stir the pot. But I was in Washington, D.C. this past weekend for a longer 5-day weekend, if you will. And I was really excited because I ran into the hobby in Washington, D.C. in the form of some Willie Mays game-used memorabilia at the Smithsonian American History Museum. I was really excited to see that that aspect was definitely called out and incorporated into American history, so that was pretty cool. Between that, the National, and James at Comic-Con, holy cow, we got just, it's been crazy. So let's, without further ado, if you're ready, Ivan, let's just dive right into it, okay?
Yeah, for sure.
All right, so let's take a look at news, note, bits and nuggets from around the web in this episode of Hobby Happenings. Well, this past Sunday, Heritage Auctions concluded its annual summer trading card auction. Over 2,000 lots sold, realizing a final total over $8.3 million, with eight cards exceeding six figures alone. The auction included several cards from PSA founder David Hall's personal T206 collection, which we've told you about in recent weeks. Well, the top-selling cards from that collection so far were this only known example of that Walter Johnson hands at chest broadleaf back, which sold for $108,000. And then this Ty Cobb red portrait with red Hindu back for $126,000. But it was this Eddie Plank sweet corporal back, which sold for over a quarter of $1 million, $252,000. But that was not the top selling item in the auction as a whole. No, it was this 1953 Topps Mickey Mantle graded in a PSA 9, which set a new price record by leaps and bounds. It sold for $396,000. It's one of only 10 nines on record, and it crushed the old mark of $87,768 that was set in 2009. Now, I'm not very good at math, but I'm pretty sure that that's almost four times in the span of just 10 years. Nice.
Very cool. In other news, Leaf Trading Cards issued a statement regarding 2019 Ultimate Football, saying, due to issues beyond Leaf's control, Ryan Finley's cards will be replaced with 2019 Leaf Flash Devin Bush autographs, which were unreleased previously, and adding that Bush's cards are worth substantially more than Finley's, but we want to be more than fair with our apologies.
Very cool.
Allegedly.
Speaking of allegedly, excuse me, I had a hair in my mouth. PWCC owner Brent Huggins has hired a high-profile New York lawyer by the name of Jeffrey Lichtman, who is himself a collector and, ironically enough, for years has been a very vocal critic of Huggins in recent years on the Net54 message board. Lichtman posted this statement on Net54 this past Monday, stating why he chose to take the case. Quote, since I began representing Brent, he has been cooperating with the FBI, has reached out to people who purchase altered cards from PWCC and refunded money, and is providing all documentation from his dealings with any and all hobby dealers and consigners. He goes on to say, unlike the Bill Mastro case, where defendants actually destroyed records, cooperated minimally, and refused to pay back a single dollar of restitution to their victims, I'm actually accomplishing more with Brent to assist the government in getting victims paid back and to stop the fraud. This is why I decided to take the case after consulting with the FBI. In addition, Brent and other dealers have agreed to put money into a restitution fund to refund money to people who purchased altered cards even years ago, well past the statute of limitations time period, even though they are not required to do so by law. As a collector, I'm less concerned with why clients decide to assist the government than with the actual impact of their cooperation. And yes, I have represented people who have cooperated with the government in connection with the hobby and have still gone to prison. If anyone doubts that what I am doing with Brent and other hobbyists who I have represented is a net positive, I'd invite you to call the FBI agent who has run all of these cases to date and investigates and ask him if he's happy that I'm representing Brett. And if it's good enough for the FBI agent who is helping to prosecute these cases, I hope that it would be good enough for you. If not, it won't be the first time someone was unhappy with who I am representing. But helping to put Mastro in jail didn't accomplish enough to stop fraud and make fraud victims whole. In this way, at least something positive is being done. We mentioned Lichtman being a high-profile attorney. Well, his past clients outside the hobby have included John Gotti Jr., Fat Joe the Rapper, and the recently convicted Joaquin El Chapo Guzman.
My only question is, who gets to play him in the movie? Sports Collectors Daily shared that a Portland TV station recently talked with a hobby shop owner in Oregon who hopes you can use his own experiences as a lesson about autograph authenticity. Watch this for more.
An autograph from your favorite player is often considered a high-dollar prized possession. Since most fans won't meet their hero on the field or in person, they go shopping. But Haley Rush with the Fox 12 Investigators found it's easy to strike out and buy a fake. She shares this collectibles consumer warning.
Imagine finding the perfect John Hancock, whether it's on a jersey, ball, or card, and it's at the perfect price. Home run, right? Well, we bought sports memorabilia ourselves and found that's not always the case.
Hey guys. How's it going?
You could call Chris Tinder crazy for collectibles.
As a kid, I was always hunting that one great card.
He owns his own store in Beaverton, the Sports Room, after all.
What are you asking for?
I was asking to.
But in the game of collecting, there's a losing side.
This had been in my man cave for, gosh, I want to say 3 or 4 years.
One Tinder knows too well.
He didn't even take it out of the frame. He took 2 seconds at it, and he was like, no, it's no good. I think it was about 4 or 5 Mickey Mantle pieces that turned out to be not legit. You feel he got ripped off.
Since buying the Sports Room and everything in it about a year ago, he even found phonies in his own inventory.
Some of them passed, some of them didn't, unfortunately. It's a sad part of our industry.
But Tinder says if you want to score, shops like his are often a sports collector's safest play.
This pen stops so many times on the M just alone. You can see where someone had just really kind of taken the time to get that M right.
Since the merchandise is usually verified and buyers get a money back guarantee.
And I think it's important as shop owners or people that go to card shows and set up tables that we're there to kind of educate people on their autographs. And if we can't help them, then we have the right resources to point them in the right direction.
He says it's online where you'll find the most foul balls.
And that's kind of heartbreaking too when someone says they got this on eBay, they paid so many hundreds of dollars for it.
The Fox 12 investigators decided to go online and buy 4 autographed items, costing a total of a little more than $200. A Peyton Manning football, a Yasiel Puig baseball, and for the Blazers fans, a Damian Lillard signed photo and jersey. We then sent the items to one of the top certification companies in the country, hoping for a grand slam, only to be told the Manning and Puig signatures aren't worth a dime.
Swindled, I guess, would be the best word. You know, and it's not necessarily the person who sold it to you because they might have been swindled too. And before then, you know, so you really just kind of wonder, like, who started this? What was their motivation? Be very, very wary.
Tinder says if you do find something you want to buy, don't be afraid to reach out to your local card shop or a professional for guidance. Also, do all the research you can online and ask the seller lots of questions. He says one of the biggest red flags is if an item online doesn't have a card or certificate of authorization with it. The certificate should also be from a nationally recognized company. For more information, head to our website, kptv.com. In studio, Haley Rush, Fox 12 Oregon.
In other court news, Topps is taking to the court. The court, not the courts. That's right, the tennis court. A new set offered by the company pays homage to the International Tennis Hall of Fame. The set includes 48 past greats of the game, as well as 2 active competitors, future Hall of Famer Roger Federer and Naomi Osaka. Other stars teased for inclusion in the set include Martina Navratilova, Billie Jean King, and Andre Agassi, to name a few. The 50-card set costs $19.99 and is available via tops.com along with the complete checklist.
Well, this week, a happy collector in Britain took to Twitter to show off this recent pull from a Topps Walking Dead box, only to have Jeffrey Dean Morgan himself, who plays Negan on the AMC critically acclaimed TV show, reply with this tweet. I'm about 87% sure that's not my signature. More. It's kind of close, but there would always be a Y in Jeffrey. Always. And transition from D to Morgan is wrong. F's are also F'd up. Yeah, that's forged. People suck. Now, we've actually seen this before. Ivan, do you remember whose card that was? I can't remember.
It was the Tommy Flanagan.
Tommy Flanagan from Yeah, Guardians of the Galaxy, and better known, I think, Sons of Anarchy. But they had forgotten signing the stickers from the manufacturer, so chances are, so did Jeffrey Dean Morgan. I'm pretty sure this is legit. Don't worry, guys.
Blowout Buzz reports that Sports Collectors Digest, whose parent company, F Plus W Media, recently filed for bankruptcy, has a new home in Active Interest Media. Good for you guys. The collectibles division acquired by AIM includes coverage of antiques, automotive, music, sports, coins, and military memorabilia. President and CEO Andrew Klerman said, "We're thrilled to welcome all 67 staff dedicated to these brands to the AIM family, and we will maintain the existing operations and team in Cincinnati, Ohio, and Stevens Point, Wisconsin, while providing support that will help drive growth from our video, digital marketing, and creative services units in AIM's Boulder headquarters. Founded in 1973, SCD is the longest-running hobby publication today. It was purchased by Kraus Publications in 1981 and F Plus W in 2002, so we're happy to hear that their run will continue."
Yeah, everybody kept their job and nobody had to relocate. That's a rarity. Topps released images of the 2020 flagship design today. What do you think? I kind of like it. Not a huge fan of the way the lettering is oriented, but in all honesty, it's kind of remarkable after all these years, really, that they can still come up with something even slightly different from year to year. Let us know what you guys think in the various chat rooms.
Is it too much to ask for a bubblegum border? Topps 3D baseball cards return this year as an online exclusive through Topps On Demand. The cards utilize a plastic, multi-layered stock of select 2019 Topps baseball cards via its online distribution platform. They are currently available through Topps.com for the next 27 days, and they will ship in October. The set takes the 100 best cards from 2019 Topps Series 1, Series 2, and Topps Update, and gives them a three-dimensional look. No glasses required. They'll come in 8-card packs for $20, with 6 3D base cards and 2 rookie class motion inserts per pack, which is one more base card and one less insert card than in the 3D packs last year, for those of you keeping track. A checklist has not yet been released.
And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. All right. Anything you want to unpack before we dive into the first of two box break segments?
Rob, I apologize. I didn't catch this one in the pre-show, mainly because I was just reading the purple, not the blue. The general consensus is not that they were stickers that were forgotten or shifted, like in the case of our actor with Upper Deck. It looks like they are a different actor's.
So the wrong sticker.
Because you've got Jeffrey Dean Morgan in The Walking Dead, and you've got Jeffrey D. Munn.
Ooh.
Who both look very similar overall.
Okay.
But there are some distinct differences, and many are saying that they believe it to be Jeffrey DeMunn's stickers accidentally put on
Dean Morgan's cards. Well, so. there you go.
But that,
see,
isn't,
that happens.
Important. One of the big things that it got me a little bit seeing the response to this, the amount of people that want to pile on with outrage and pitchforks, the amount of people saying Topps is forging autographs. It's like,
dude,
hold on,
right?
Like, let's just look at it.
Yeah.
Why would Topps forge an autograph when they can just leave a person off the checklist? And when it's this easy nowadays to get caught doing that, that's just silly to
assume. No. Yeah. Nobody's going to do that.
Just back up and wait. And there's a clear explanation. Yeah. Someone might've made a mistake, but
it always comes down to the common denominator, right? What's the easiest, most plausible thing that probably happened? Yes, that's a good call.
Agent signed the stickers.
Agent signed the stickers. Actor forgot that he signed the stickers, or the stickers were switched around. Not that they were forged.
Yeah,
let's not.
Topps,
you know,
sitting back there, like, who's the biggest actor in this set? Let's forge their autograph. On.
Right. Nobody will notice.
Especially because there are other Topps products with on-card autographs of Jeffrey Dean Morgan, so you can literally compare Topps cards to see that.
Yeah. I also thought it was pretty interesting. A lot of people are calling for, you know, they're pointing out PWCC as the major culprit in this altered cards affair. But there are some people that are, you know, definitely upset at grading companies, PSA in particular. But if you ask me, when you talk about the volume of cards PWCC sells versus the volume of cards that PSA grades, I'm probably willing a little bit more to let some things slide. But again, it goes back to that we are in an era where none of this needs to happen. This can all be done by technology, and anything altered can be flagged like that without even the need for a human eye or a ruler. So this story is far from over. We'll see what happens, obviously.
Not to mention, again, you know me, I like to break, I'm always centrist. So if you say one thing, I gotta say the other side. If collectors are saying one thing, I gotta say the other side. For the last 2.5 years, do you know what I have heard from collectors, Rob?
No, what have you heard, Ivan?
Grade faster! Grade faster!
Yeah.
And it's like, there's a balance there. And I kept saying to people, like, yeah, we all want that, but let's also figure out a way to scale. And we've seen the companies hiring and hiring new people. And it's like, you know, let's give them just a little leeway to figure that out. And so, I don't know, there is that, you know, I want to hope that PSA is not culpable completely. I want to hope there's a solution, because honestly, you know me, I like graded cards because they help me with some of the judgment things that I'm not good at, like autograph
authentication. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's a necessary entity in the hobby. All right, so 4 boxes to break from Topps tonight, thanks to Suze at Topps. We've got Allen and Ginter, Topps WWE SummerSlam, the Walmart exclusive Bowman Platinum, and Topps Archive Signature Series.
Ooh, even more fun.
Given how busy we are tonight, I pre-broke this box just in the half hour leading up to the show. But to do it justice, I pulled a good sampling of cards of what you can find. So let's start with some base cards. You've got rookies like Chicago White Sox, Michael Kopech. Luis Urias from the Padres. Vladimir Guerrero Jr. This guy, he's pretty good. Victor Robles. And then you've got some fun cards to see as I was going through. How about Robbie Alomar in a Blue Jays uniform? You know, most people automatically identify him probably with the Indians, but he was a Jay for a long time. Hey, Big Mac and that smile. That was fun. And an even better smile, newly inducted Hall of Famer Mariano Rivera. The captain, Derek Jeter. And then this was fun. How about Willie Stargell? That's always great when you get to see Stargell coming out of a pack. Classic Sandy Koufax picture. Another guy with a great smile, Hank Aaron. Gone too soon, Roberto Clemente. And then the always stoic Babe Ruth. But for my money, one of the best base cards of the baseball set, portion of the base set, rather, was this card. The Cincinnati Red Sockings. This is the 1869. Remember, they found an original of this, went for a ton of money. Well, it's got a Ginter card now, so that's probably the closest we'll ever get to holding that. That's pretty cool. And then you've got, of course, we got to check out the non-baseball subjects, personalities. First, Tiger Mask.
Nice.
Luca Libre, our Japanese wrestler. AJ Andrews, who's a softball player and won a prestigious fielding award. Travis Pastrana, daredevil extraordinaire. This little girl, Haley Dawson, who pitched a first pitch at every ballpark with a prosthetic hand. Sweetie. We've got Drew Daschle, American Ninja Warrior. We have Mason Cox. World Series of Poker player Sin. We have musician Quinn Casey. I don't know what that is. Never heard of him. Charles Marnett. The good thing is if you haven't heard about them, they've got these really detailed write-ups on the back. There's Ray Butcher, stand-up comic actor. Mark Summers, double dare ya. There's Oz, and I'm glad he just went with Oz on the card. Augie Carton, one of the strongest men in the world, Oberst. Hillary Knight. And Burton Rocks. So those were our non-baseball subjects. Then our minis in no particular order, and we'll check for variations as we go through because I didn't have time to do that. Jay Larson, comedian. This is a black border, Aaron Judge, regular back. Bryce Harper. Ooh, that's a funky back. We have... It's an AG back. World champions. AG back of Bryce Harper. There's Haley Dawson. Oh, with an AG back too. Cool. I know they're the most common, but that's still cool. Yeah. Lost Languages. The Carolina Algonquin. Lookout Below Yosemite Falls in a mini horizontal. You don't see many of those. That's pretty cool in that orientation. And here's another one. Dreams of Blue Ribbons Hot Dog Eating Contest. Regular back. Ronald Acuna Jr. Black Border Parallel. Regular back. George Springer. Regular back. Let's see. Kyle Snyder. Freestyle Wrestler. And that's got an AG back as well. Collectible canines. I was hoping to pull a boxer, but Bernese Mountain Dog, they're still cool. J.A. Happ, regular back. Torrey Hunter, regular back. Juan Marichal, with an AG back. Alex Bregman, regular back. Another collectible canine, the Rhodesian Ridgeback. Very cool dog.
Nice.
Phil Rizzuto, regular back. Mark McGuire, regular. Freddie Freeman, AG back. Jose Ramirez, regular back, but black border. Brandon Nemo, regular back. Cody Allen, regular back. Willie McCovey, regular back. And Dustin Pedroia, regular back. So that was the minis. Then there's some pretty fun insert sets to be found, as you would expect. Get these out of the way here. This is Baseball All-Stars. All-Star Signs. So... little Zodiac action going on there. Mike Trout, Tony Gwynn, Kershaw, Chris Bryant, Francisco Lindor, Rhys Hoskins. Then Ginter Greats, greatest to ever hold a bat and ball. Cal Ripken Jr., Rod Carew, Randy Johnson, Ken Griffey Jr., Honus Wagner, and Ricky Henderson. Incredible equipment. Rosie the Riveter's work gloves. Now that'd be a cool relic. Merlin's staff. King Arthur's sword. And Poseidon's trident. So there was kind of a theme with three of those four cards going on there. And then... now, I don't know. I know you saw this, Ivan. Beckett did an awesome GIF of this next one.
Oh, yeah.
I don't have... Do you know how many cards are in the panorama?
I want to say that it's 18.
Yeah, and I didn't get 18 by any stretch of the imagination, but since I was at the National Air and Space Museum, it was cool to pull at least four of these cards. But what's great is all 18 lay end to end to make this one scene. So that's a pretty cool chase that you could build and then actually, you know, display, you know, just putting them into top loaders end to end to end to end. That would look really, really cool. And the color just pops from, you know, the rest of the tinting that we're used to in vintage. So very fun. I really dig these History of Flight inserts. More animals, mares and stallions. That first one was Morgan Horse. This is Thoroughbred, Cleveland Bay, and Kentucky Mountain Horse. Then we've got some hits. Every box. What is every box, Ivan, going to deliver?
Am I the only one who's never gotten into different types of horses?
Like,
I'm into different dogs. Kind of into different cats, but different horses. Three hits.
Okay. Any three of these cards in every box. Autograph, relic, rip, printing plates, and book cards.
Or original Allen and Ginter buybacks.
Nice.
Or we cut have signatures.
A pinstripe.
I'm guessing you didn't get either of those, though.
Jersey card of Ian Happ.
Cool.
A jersey card of Rafael Devers and an on-card autograph of rookie Patrick Wisdom of the Texas Rangers.
I thought for sure it was going to be Ryan O'Hearn.
No. But our box actually over-delivered.
Ooh, fourth hit? Fourth pack. Box fourth, topper?
Fourth hit. A double rip card.
Whoa!
So there's Cabrera and K-Line.
Whoa.
And it's numbered, as you can see, to just 20. So we call that, what do we call that here, boys? Boom!
You know, can you flip it back around to the Cabrera side for a minute? And Rob, I mean, it's live on the air. God, you set me up perfectly for my constant debate. Do you know my feelings about the rip card, Rob? Do you know how I treat it or how I believe it should be treated?
I don't know how you feel, but I know you gotta rip it.
No, you never rip it. You never rip it.
I'm ripping it.
That's been my stance for so long. You never rip it. 1 in 99 rip cards has something better inside. No, you're killing it right now. You're killing it. Numbered to just 20. We could have given that away. Someone could have sold it and bought their own box. That was two Hall of Famers on one card.
Tough.
And look, all you got is a blank piece of paper inside. I called it.
Juan Soto Mini.
Well, that's actually not that bad. Is there two sides to it, or is it
that's
just?
That's why it's called a double rip card.
Oh, but you can't just get it through the inside.
Uh-uh.
PV Meister says the rip card is still valuable after being ripped. Yeah, it's worth like $6. They've been selling for $5 to $12. Generally, the base cards inside will sell for about $40, whereas you can sell an unripped double rip card for significantly more than that.
How about a numbered to 10 auto on card of Franmil Reyes? There you go.
Can you stand that up again real quick with your hands? It looks much better when you do that because it's so small. There we go. No comment.
No, I'm going to put it back in the rip card, and someone is going to win the rip card. I'm putting them both back in the rip card.
stalking PMS in the Twitch chat, and this is where Ivan turns into a corn cob. Okay, Rob, so you may have got me this time with a red ink auto, but I still stand by my thesis. Still stand sharply by my thesis.
All right, so we'll give away the rookie on-card auto and the rip card as it stands there, and another lucky winner, one winner, will get both relic cards. So three winners out of this box. I have never had any kind of serious luck in Ginter, so when I saw a double rip card, I knew I was ripping it. Plus, I was going to rip it anyway, just because it makes for good TV. All right, and every box comes with an oversized box topper. Now, I've never, ever, 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 ever pulled an autographed version of one of these. That would be amazing. Congratulations. Well, if everybody gets one, so what's to be congratulated? But it's still really cool looking. How about that Mookie Betts? It's even too big for the
box topper at all.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Let's go ahead and give that away too. So four winners.
Are all the box toppers on that design, or is that design a special
insert? I'm not sure.
Box toppers.
I'm not sure. Just making sure you heard me, bro. We'll give that away too. Four winners for Ginter.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, sorry, right. I was typing because I wanted to get the tweet out.
No problem.
Cool, but.
Yeah, that's one of the better boxes of Ginter I've ever opened, and some good stuff in there. So I hope, even though we didn't open every pack by pack, you guys got a good sampling of what's to be found this year. All right. While you do that, we do have another 24-pack box to go through. And given that it's WWE, I was going to try to get to this one too, just because of how much we have going on tonight, but I couldn't. So I'm going to start ripping SummerSlam. WWE is one of their premier pay-per-view events of the summer. In fact, the one is going to deliver two hits, one being a guaranteed autograph card. The Ronda Rousey tribute continues. So, nice blazing design, Liv Morgan, The Miz, The Man, Becky Lynch, greatest Royal Rumble moment, SummerSlam All-Stars, there's Brock Lesnar, little SmackDown Live action, and SummerSlam greatest matches and moments. This is when Kurt Angle defeated Brock Lesnar. That was great. There's some,
so I will say,
yeah, go ahead.
Sorry, just because I'm just getting my speech back. Getting the Soto rip card, which is not a bad, because remember the minis inside are exclusives also, so they're different than the standard minis. With the Franmil Reyes number to 10 red ink auto, that's pretty good.
Yeah,
that's pretty good. That's as far as I'll go. But if you want your chance to win any of the prizes that we talked about from that last box, make sure that you go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive and retweet the tweet with the rip card, the double rip card. Oh, who made fun of me in that tweet? Come on. Come on, guys. Well, fair enough.
Naomi? So you're not just getting roster, you're getting SummerSlam All-Stars, a look back at past matches, even going old school with someone like Alondra Blaze from years ago. And I'm glad we're getting WWE again. It seemed like it had been a while. It seemed like we'd missed a couple releases. Here we've got a Carmella match used swatch card.
So you know what's really cool too, because WWE has such a diverse roster, if you want to know who the autograph signers are in this particular product, our website gogts.net has downloadable checklists, so you can just open up the PDF checklist and search for the name of your favorite wrestler. Who's your favorite wrestler right now, Rob?
Right now on the roster, I would say in the women's division, it would probably be I kind of like Becky Lynch until she like flipped heel a little bit. I still like Charlotte. Gosh, I can't name a favorite. Men's division is a lot tougher too.
Well, I can tell you Becky Lynch has autographs on her Matt Relic.
Oh, that'd be sick. That'd be sick.
Yeah. Because you know what I just did? I searched the checklist, found that information in a second. So yeah.
I hate this guy. I like Braun Strowman. That dude's just an animal.
I like him just because...
Oh, wow. Boom. AJ Styles on card auto. Sweet. One of the top roster talents.
Yeah, hold that for just another second.
Sorry, awesome. I'll put it back.
That's perfect.
Oh, you got it? Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so we'll give both of those hits away, and I'm going to take a quick gander through the rest of these.
Kevin oh, I did Owens miss. What was the first hit?
Is Carmella Matt Relic.
Gotcha.
Drew McIntyre, Sami Zayn, AJ Styles, Xavier Woods, Triple H. Not any sort of cadence to how these cards are inserted. Some, there's a disproportionate ratio of greatest moments to, it's not like you're guaranteed two and then three bays. Oh, that's cool. What is this, posters? This is a SummerSlam 2014 poster spotlight insert card found in 2019. Gosh, I like the poster cards. That's cool. That'd be a nice insert set to collect. Oh, who can remember Randy Savage marrying Miss Elizabeth?
I'm going to go out on a limb here and say you can.
Mandy Rose. Yeah, she's probably one of my favorites right now. I watched her through the Tough Enough competition. And even though she didn't win it, I knew she was going to get a contract. I knew it. And she did. SummerSlam poster. That's a great one, too. Yeah, I like those.
Wow, I just jumped on the Periscope chat. We've got over 50 people watching on Periscope. Sorry that I missed everybody there. If you had good comments, sorry that I missed them. But that's pretty exciting.
To give you guys an idea of what we have coming up next, we'll... do part one of our San Diego Comic-Con coverage, and then it's our big national preview segment.
Steven Radford just joined us on Facebook. Nice to see you there, Steven.
Glad she's back, Selena Vega. Great SummerSlam poster. Boom.
I do feel kind of bad. There's a chat going on in Twitch about where I don't watch the show anymore, and obviously it's live stream. A big part of that is I can only run so much bandwidth on my computer, and for whatever reason, live stream seems to take up the most bandwidth. Twitch has almost 50 people in it, and it
I like
doesn't
Oscar
slow
too.
My computer down at all.
There's the Ronda Rousey tribute cards.
Who's Oscar 2? Can you hear me?
I said Asuka.
Oh. Asuka. Oh, yeah. Asuka?
Asuka. I was corrected about that about a year and a half ago, I remember. Oh, Jim the Anvil Neidhart died this year. Another rowdy Ronda Rousey tribute card. That's a classic photo that's been used quite frequently. Randy Orton and John Cena from SummerSlam.
Oh, wow, we just had a brand new viewer, Body on Press. It's their first day on Periscope.
Welcome.
That's pretty cool.
So the Ronda cards are top heavy, or I should say backloaded towards the back of this box, the bottom portion, if you're working on that set. And you're allowed to pick your own packs. Nia Jax, Kurt Angle, Bray Wyatt, who's just returned. Bayley closes things out. All right, so as we told you, James had an opportunity to attend San Diego Comic-Con. If you don't know who James is, he's the guy that does all the magic behind the scenes, make sure we look good, sound good, all that stuff. So he was on hand visiting some of your favorite manufacturers, including Topps, Upper Deck, Cryptozoic, and got some really good content, and this is part one. Check it out. We'll be back and dive into our preview of the National Sports Collectors Convention.
Comic-Con. I'm Tyler, Upper Deck Entertainment Manager, Marketing Manager. We've basically used the last several years to showcase our gallery prints that we've been spending some time building. It's the Upper Deck Gallery. They're generally available online at upperdeckgallery.com, but we find that these conventions, these fan shows, are a really great place to get the art on the walls in front of the people that are most likely to enjoy them. To that end, you know, we brought an exclusive this year, which is Spider-Man in his symbiote suit versus Mysterio, limited to only 100 pieces, and it's got green foil. It's a really cool piece. It's black and green looking. And then we've got this really cool trading card set, which is a 17-card set. And it's a collection of our favorite gallery images brought together in a collectible pack. It's $10, there's 17 cards, and it's limited to 1,500 across the whole convention. We're kind of getting some out each day. So we're just really excited to be able to showcase all of the original art that we've brought into the gallery since we've been making original art for Marvel through our trading card and gaming products so long. So just enjoying ourselves and meeting the fans.
Oh.
That was very cool. All right, I can't wait to see more of that. All right, let's dive right into our preview because there is a lot going on. Obviously, as you probably all know, the 40th annual National Sports Collectors Convention begins next week at the Donald E. Stevens Convention Center in Rosemont, Illinois, just outside Chicago. So here's a look at all the goings-on.
Things kick off with the national VIP party on Wednesday. Excuse me, I'm so excited. I'm getting choked up. This year's sponsor for the national VIP party is Pristine Auctions. The event includes free food and free autograph signers from 3 to 4 p.m. This year's free signers are Chicago Bulls legend Bill Cartwright, Drew Pearson, and Ryan Klesko. VIP ticket holders are also invited to attend a panel discussion on the future of trading cards with Gary Vaynerchuk and entrepreneur Josh Luber at 2 p.m. That looks exciting.
PSA, once again, has a bunch of fun activities going on at this year's show. Mm-hmm. To start, PSA is hosting a Jordan a Day giveaway, daily sweepstakes, and we'll be giving away a trio of 1986 Fleer Michael Jordan rookie cards, one per day on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. The three different PSA graded cards are an 8, an 8.5, wow, and a 9, and will be randomly awarded. Sweepstakes entries can be made in person at the PSA booth, number 1436, stage left, or online at psacard.com/national, which is cool.
Hold on.
Can't be there. Winners need not be present and will be announced at 4 p.m. Central Time daily at the PSA booth during each of the three designated days.
Give me 3 minutes on my segment. I got to enter to win that right now. Just kidding. Showgoers will also have the opportunity to take home personal encapsulated trading cards in special PSA labeled holders as they have in years past. This time around, the cards, which are sponsored by Love of the Game Auctions, will feature a tobacco card twist. That's right. Visit the PSA booth to be featured on your very own T206 trading card. As always, the card is 100% free to all PSA booth visitors.
In addition, PSA has produced a limited edition set of 5 2019 NSCC promo cards that features baseball legends Ty Cobb, Honus Wagner, Christy Mathewson, Nap Lajoie, and Shoeless Joe Jackson. If anybody scores the Shoeless Joe, hook a brother up. Exclusively distributed at the National, the complete set of all 5 promo cards will be given to new PSA Platinum Collectors Club members. New PSA Gold Collectors Club members will be randomly awarded one of the 5 promo cards. Promo card set is being sponsored by Mile High Card Company.
And Rob, we discussed earlier PSA's need to hire more graders. Well, guess what? For the first time ever, PSA is hosting a tryout. Well, not exactly. They're actually hosting a national card grading competition at this year's National. The contest will be open to 77 contestants only and will be held at PSA's corporate booth, with the overall winner walking away with a $1,000 check.
That's awesome.
Pretty cool. The entry fee for this competition is $20, and each participant will have 15 minutes to grade 25 encapsulated vintage and modern trading cards. To sign up, visit PSA's National Card Grading landing page. The winner will be announced on Saturday, August 3rd at 4 p.m. Central Time at the PSA booth.
If that's any sort of indication, the time spent on cards, you can do the math. That's less than a minute a card.
Ooh, set your timers.
Beckett has some fun stuff going on as well. They'll host its now annual party once again on Thursday night of the National. Beckett Night at the Ballpark features an all-you-can-eat buffet. Wow. Hundreds of prizes, attendee goodie bags, A, and a special autograph signing and meet and greet with 1983 AL Rookie of the Year winner Ron Kittle. That's cool.
Sorry, I'm looking at that. Which ballpark is that?
It's near the where the Chicago Bandit softball team plays.
Oh, so who's actually playing?
I don't know.
Nobody tells me anything. In addition, though, Beckett will once again be hosting its popular Beckett Cover Card Scavenger Hunt Contest. Each day, a set number of collectors who are the first to find each of the various cards located at various vendor locations around the convention center will win a blind-wrapped 8x10 autograph. Be sure to visit the Beckett booth for more details and the complete cover card checklist and hopefully where to find them as well. Also on Sunday, Rick Harrison of the hit TV show Pawn Stars will be on hand to meet fans, but much more importantly, to offer you hard cash for your memorabilia items.
Nice. Be sure to stop by the Wax Pack Nation booth to grab a free t-shirt while supplies last and to meet the famed card artist Tim Carroll, who will be on hand working on one of his masterpieces.
After a tremendous success last year, the National is partnering again with a local charity, along with partnership with Handbid Auctions, to bring one lucky family staying at the Ronald McDonald House to this year's show. Handbid is currently running a charity auction and will be on hand for attendees to view and bid on these items. All proceeds from the charity auction will go to benefit the Ronald McDonald House.
Comp C, formerly known as Check Out My Cards, will be on hand with several promotional opportunities. Stop by their booth in the corporate pavilion to, for starters, spin the prize wheel.
I love it. Can I spin?
They'll also be accepting submissions, explaining how the service works, and providing discounted show specials. Visit the Comp C blog for more details. In addition, the folks at Comp C have partnered with Instagram user CardCollector2 to host an exclusive trade night. You must be an Instagram user to attend, so be sure to follow either Check Out My Cards or CardCollector2 to find out the event's secret location.
Ooh. Our friends at Signatures for Soldiers will be on hand selling autographed items, with all proceeds going to help disabled veterans through the charitable work of Military Missions in Action. Be sure to stop by their booth. They will be set up in the Ripping Wax Case Break Pavilion. They will also be accepting donations of unused VIP autograph tickets and any unopened packs to be included in 9,000 care packages being sent to active duty military personnel serving overseas. And if you aren't going to attend but you still want to know how to support, check out SIGS for Soldiers on Twitter at SIGS for Soldiers. And if you need supplies while at the National, Ultra Pro has you covered. Check them out at booth 870, where they will be offering a ton of freebies while supplies last, including the cool dual tool card gauges inspired by our own viewer, Larry Robidoux. They'll also have the Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Beckett cover card for that scavenger hunt we talked about, as well as samples of Ultra Pro's new platinum sports sleeves. They will also be hosting an all-day raffle for a variety of supplies, and every afternoon they will host a raffle for signed memorabilia items. In addition, they will host two daily breaks facilitated by Joel Richford, our friend from The Loot Locker. 10 to 12 kids per day can participate in each break, where they'll receive cards, of course, as well as accessories from Ultra Pro and a My First Break breaker mat. It's a lot of fun.
You can see him in that picture there. That's cool. During the five-day convention, an estimated 35,000 autographs from about 130 athletes and celebrities will be signed for the public. Houston-based TriStar Productions will once again be hosting the Autograph Pavilion that will encompass close to 40,000 square feet. TriStar Vice President Bobby Mintz told Sports Collectors Digest that about 2,500 Sharpies, mostly blue, will be used along with 500 ballpoint pens for baseballs. TriStar officials said about 10,000 photos will be signed, along with 5,000 footballs and 15,000 baseballs. But in addition to hosting the autograph pavilion, TriStar CEO and founder Jeff Rosenberg will be on hand with cash to purchase your autographed memorabilia. Also, you may remember that earlier this year, TriStar purchased the massive signed baseball collection of PSA lead authenticator Kevin Keating. The entire collection will be on display and individually able for purchase.
I'll be ready with my $5. Collectors will have the chance to hold a bat once used by Lou Gehrig. How cool does that sound? Well, check out Memory Lane, who has an entire exhibit featuring dozens of items from the life and career of the baseball icon. Nearly 50 Hall of Fame-worthy items from Gehrig's life and Hall of Fame career will be on exhibit at Memory Lane's booth. That's number 1108, just inside the main entrance. Each day from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m., attendees will have an opportunity to hold a photo-matched Gehrig game model bat from the early 1930s that is part of the collection.
The SGC Museum display at the 2019 National Sports Collectors Convention will feature a never-before-seen exhibit. Listen up, Ivan. It's going to feature a trio of historic Cubs jerseys. SGC promises you'll see something you've never seen before and will most likely never see again. A collection of game-worn jerseys of that trio of Bear Cubs, Tinkers to Evers to Chance. This beyond rare grouping of early 20th century game-worn Cubs uniforms was acquired in the past year through a private transaction by a collector who has loaned them to the exhibit. SGC uniform authenticator Dave Grob himself remarked, "If I had previously not had the honor and pleasure of examining these jerseys, I'd be making a special trip to Chicago just to see them and bask in their history and significance." The SGC Museum display will be located at booth 824.
The Baseball Card King and BCW Supplies are providing a free sleeves and top loader station at this year's National Sports Collectors Convention at booth 646. While supplies last, free sleeves and top loaders for standard 2.5 by 3.5 cards, as well as thick cards, will be available for the special NSCC cards that collectors acquire at the show. That's pretty cool.
Yep.
Additional supplies for other cards and memorabilia will, of course, be on for sale from the Baseball Card King, also at booth 646. Please ask the team at the booth if you have any questions.
That's nice.
In news I'm looking forward to, eBay will again be a corporate sponsor and providing attendees a wide range of activities. Stop by their booth, I know I will, to meet one-on-one with a representative who can answer any questions you have about their sports collectibles marketplace. This is a great opportunity to bring up some of your experiences and also learn tips for better listing. They will also be hosting multiple raffles with several different ways to enter. Plus, don't miss the chance to score a $50 eBay gift card. I'm in for that too, which will be raffled off Thursday through Sunday, four times a day, with actual times to be determined still. Also, in partnership with Sports Memorabilia, there will be 25 2019 Topps Baseball Factory sets up for grabs via raffle as well. While supplies last, receive a $10 eBay coupon giveaway just for stopping by the booth.
Nice.
That's incentive enough for me.
The Mike Berkus main stage in the Ripping Wax Case Break Pavilion will be a flurry of activity as your humble hosts provide entertainment and content once again throughout the show. As you can see here, the pavilion is located near the PSA booth on the left, and to the right is the TriStar merchandise booth. And just past that, out of frame to the right, is the actual autograph pavilion. Also, you can see that Signatures for Soldiers is right there in the middle of the traffic pattern in booth 1200. Several events are scheduled to take place at the Mike Berkus main stage. Here's a day-by-day look at what's happening.
On Wednesday, the sneak peek, sponsored by Memory Lane, kicks off with an onstage signing with Dallas Cowboys great Drew Pearson that will then be immediately followed by the Topps VIP case break. Could it be a chrome jumbo case? Well, you'll just have to come find out. I'm not telling you it's going to be a chrome jumbo case. But you'll have to find out. The first full day of the show, starting at 10 a.m. Thursday, we will sit down with sports memorabilia appraiser, vintage collector, dealer, and noted hobby writer Michael Osaki. He runs various hobby entities under the umbrella of Baseball in the Attic. Michael will discuss tips on memorabilia appraisal, pitfalls to avoid in authentication, and more. This will be followed at 11 a.m. with a near case break of Onyx Vintage Collection Baseball with owner and founder Lance Fisher on stage with us. Spots are free. Just come by and grab a raffle ticket.
Then be sure to stick around when Gary V takes the stage to talk about being the subject of a trading card, his impressions of being a first-timer at the National, and his take on the current state of the hobby and where it goes from here. That'll be followed quickly then by the never at a loss for words, Kevin Hefner of Historic Autograph, who will hit the stage at 2 p.m., and we can only guess what he has in store for attendees, but we can guarantee you this, it will be a must-see event. And if all that wasn't enough, then Daryl McKay of Baseball Treasure stops by for a chat. We'll discuss the GTS exclusive and also be fulfilling a redemption program for Baseball Treasures Limited Edition.
Friday morning starts with Drew Herndon of Let Me Get That Potograph hosting an audience interactive podcast from the stage. This podcast will feature some special guests and a Topps Chrome Jumbo box break courtesy of Mojo Break. I can confirm Topps Chrome Jumbo Box, courtesy of Mojo Break. After that, Leighton Sheldon of Vintage Breaks takes the stage for a yet-to-be-determined vintage pack break. I can pretty much guarantee it will not disappoint, though, considering you might remember last year they pulled a 1955 Bowman Mickey Mantle card that ended up grading out to a PSA 9, and that was right after pulling a Ernie Banks from that same pack. What will they pull this year? Stop by the stage and find out.
And after that, be sure to stick around for a Q&A with Jeopardy champion James Holzhauer. You might have pulled his card recently from Allen and Ginter this year. Plus, three lucky people in the audience will be randomly selected to play Hobby Jeopardy against the champ for prizes, courtesy of Topps.
The buzzers, Rob?
Oh, yeah. This will be followed by the free eBay break. Don't have a ton of details on that, so visit their booth to find out how slots will be given away and what the product's going to be. And then I'll be joining author and radio show host Tom Zappala for the Great American Collectibles Show, normally co-hosted with Boston Red Sox great Rico Petrocelli. Rico has other commitments this year, so Tom and I are going to hold down the fort. But then to close out the day, Eric Norton of the Fat Packs hosts an interactive, audience interactive podcast with guests, which includes Stu Stone, creator of the baseball card documentary Jack of All Trades. And, of course, there will be giveaways. Interestingly enough, Fat Packs also kicks off Saturday's event with even more fun starting at 10 a.m.
Gosh, Rob, are we already to Saturday? The National just flies by. I feel like I'm not even there yet. Saturday, the annual Panini Kids Break will take place at 11 a.m., hosted by Brian Gavin of Ultimate Box Breaks. This will be immediately followed by the Panini Grand Case Break with Tracy Hackler gracing the stage. We will be giving away spots for case breaks of 2019 Donruss Elite Football, 2019 Leather and Lumber Baseball, and 2019 Victory Lane Racing. Yeah, case breaks of all three of those. After that, Upper Deck is going to take the stage with their Ultimate Box Breaks experience, and the National Set Collation Contest returns for a third year to crown a new champion.
And as always, we will be hosting regular trivia contests throughout the show for packs and maybe even a complete box or two or three or four. So be sure to stop by, say hi, and hang out with us when you need a place to sit and chill. We'll also have lots of prize packs and other swag to give away, including free GoGTS Live t-shirts. And, of course, several manufacturers will have their own special promotions, activities, and events of their own, like Fanatics, who will be hosting daily sales specials, including mystery memorabilia and weekend giveaways. Collectors that purchase any box of Cryptozoic products should be sure to bring it to the redemption table in the GTS Distribution Lounge adjacent to the Casebreak Pavilion. There you can receive exclusive promo cards for not only CZX Outlander, but CZX Heroes and Villains. Plus, you'll automatically be entered into a raffle drawing for this awesome Arrow Season 4 screen-used prop, an Oliver Queen for Mayor campaign poster framed.
Nice. That'd look good in any bedroom. Leaf trading cards will once again be a busy place with multiple redemption programs taking place. Program 1 is a box-level redemption program. Open a box of 2019 Leaf in the game Use Sports or 2019 Leaf Pop Century at the Leaf Trading Cards booth. That's very important. Bring it to the booth and open it there. And you will receive a one-card pack of 1992 Leaf metal cards celebrating Leaf Trading Cards' iconic 1992 baseball release. Look for amazing multi-sport names on that design, such as Hulk Hogan, Ken Griffey Jr., Mike Tyson, Barry Sanders, Kyler Murray, Stephen Curry, Ichiro, Lionel Messi, Daisy Ridley, Ronaldinho, Harrison Ford, Larry Bird, Conor McGregor, and more.
Program 2 is a case-level redemption program. Open a case of 2019 in the game Use Sports or 2019 Leaf Pop Century at the Leaf Trading Card booth and receive a one-card pack of the 1992 Leaf Metal for each box in your case. Plus, a one-of-one autograph card from a list of names such as Ichiro, Ken Griffey Jr., Giannis Antetokounmpo, Emmitt Smith, Gordie Howe, Conor McGregor, Lionel Messi, Pele, Kyler Murray, Cristiano Ronaldo, and more. Wow.
Well, Rob, that's not all. Program 3 centers around 2019 Leaf Metal All-American Bowl football, hobby, or jumbo boxes, and includes an exclusive National Sports Collectors Convention bonus box offer. Open a case of Leaf Metal All-American Bowl football, hobby, or jumbo, and receive an exclusive 2019 National Sports Collectors Convention bonus box. Each 2019 NSCC bonus box contains 12 autograph cards, all numbered to two or less.
Does that say two?
All are numbered to two or less, but it says 12.
Wow.
Each bonus box will contain 12 autographed cards.
Well, if that wasn't enough, Leaf will also be offering two items exclusively at the 2019 National. You won't be able to get them from Blowout. You won't be able to get them from DA Card World, your hobby shop, even GTS Distribution. So look for the 2019 Leaf Metal Rookie Set boxes. Each box will contain a Leaf Rookie Set with Prismatic and Wave Match numbered sets randomly inserted. Also find 2019 Leaf autographed one-of-one proof football boxes. So each box contains two signed and slabbed one-of-one proof cards, including cards of Kyler Murray, Dwayne Haskins, and many more. Box quantities are those are extremely limited and will have strict limits on how many can be purchased. Get those directly at the Leaf booth.
We talked about Lance Fisher from Onyx joining us on the stage. Well, Onyx has a special treat in store for you, too, at their booth. Simply present a proof of a $100 purchase of Onyx products at their booth, number 872, and receive a bonus autographed card. Players featured on the bonus card are Luis Castillo and Victor Robles. This is an example of Robles' card from last year's show.
Cool. All right, well, this year's Tops Rapper Redemption Program will feature a national-branded 2019 Bowman set. Similar to last year's program, for collectors to get this exclusive these exclusive Bowman Redemption packs. You're going to have to purchase hobby boxes from a dealer at the National, receive a specially marked sticker, and then bring it to the Topps booth with the sealed box to redeem for a pack. Packs contain four exclusive Bowman cards with a chance at autographs and rare refractors. There is a limit of 12 packs per person per transaction, and packs are only available while supplies last. Each day of the show, there will be a limited number of packs available to spread it across the duration of the NSCC week. The redemption line will open Thursday through Sunday at 11:30 a.m., but Wednesday, the night of the sneak peek, the redemption line will open at 5.
In addition to the Rapper Redemption program, the Topps booth will be bustling with guest appearances, pack wars, contests, a card wall, and much more at this year's show. They will also announce their National Baseball Card Day checklist in advance of the special day on August 10th. Cincinnati Reds prospect Hunter Green is headed to Chicago. Green, the number 2 overall pick in 2017, will be signing special cards made just for the National, and they are limited to the first 100 people per day. That's going to be on Friday, 2 to 3 p.m., and Saturday, 11 a.m. to noon.
Many sports fans are certainly familiar with the great work of artist Greg Kreindler. He has worked with Topps this year on the 150 Years of Baseball set, sold exclusively on Topps.com. His artwork's been featured, has featured many of the most iconic players through baseball history. He will be on hand signing prints, included as a gift with purchase for the 150 anniversary set being sold at the National. There is a maximum of 3 autographs per person. Visit Greg on Thursday from 2 to 3 p.m.
And meet Master Chef Graham Elliott. If you didn't know this about Graham, he is a big baseball card collector as well. And as such, he was the perfect person to be featured in 2019 Topps Allen and Ginter. Well, maybe you didn't pull his autograph card, or maybe you pulled his first pitch card from Topps a few years ago. Well, now you can meet the Master Chef at the Topps booth. Well, he will sign specially made cards for the show. That will be Saturday from 2:30 to 3:30.
So much to do. Also, for the last several years, Topps has held a question and answer session with the executives in a town hall format. Collectors can come to the event, ask their burning questions while food and drinks are being served. Prizes are usually given away as well. Sign up at the Topps booth because there is a limited amount of seats available for the Thursday event, which runs from 5:30 to 7:30.
And of course, what would a Topps exhibit at the National be without Pack Wars? Hosted by the Rip Master, Alan Nars. It's loud. It's crazy. We can hear it all the way from the stage sometimes, and it's a lot of fun. To participate, go to the Topps booth at the designated times, see the show schedule on the floor for a chance to win Topps prizes, and everyone who participates and plays gets a free pack of cards. So there's no reason not to.
Along with all the autograph signers, TriStar will be hosting at this year's National. They will also have bonus bags for collectors who buy boxes from select retailers at the show and bring them to the TriStar booth to open. 8 TriStar Hidden Treasures products are eligible for bonus bags this year and could include items like a Ryan Sandberg autographed jersey or autographed items from Pele, Ted Williams, Walter Payton, Jason Momoa, Sandy Koufax, and more. In addition, you'll also automatically be entered into a drawing to win a Kirby Puckett inscribed baseball. Sweet.
I'm not saying I voted for them in our poll. I will say Upper Deck also has a massive set of activities and happenings going on at the National. Upper Deck's Rapper Redemption programs will be available throughout the show for exclusive Prominent Cuts Black Packs. Visit an Upper Deck Diamond certified diamond dealer on the show floor, which you can usually identify by the giant yellow balloons at their booth. Purchase a sealed hobby box that qualifies for the program and score. Upper Deck takes the wrappers, you keep the cards, and you will be gifted a special Upper Deck Black Pack that features show exclusive content, including Prominent Cuts, top shelf NHL rookie cards, and of course, autographs.
Monumental returns from Upper Deck Authenticated with 125 blind boxes featuring 5 signed UDA multi-sport items per box for $1,000 plus tax. There will be several spokesperson-themed hot boxes where multiple items will be signed by a superstar athlete like Ben Simmons, Serena Williams, Tiger Woods, Wayne Gretzky, Connor McDavid, LeBron James, or Michael Jordan. There will also be larger-than-life redemptions for items too large to fit in the monumental boxes that will be fulfilled on-site. One very important note. In the past, this product has been allocated to a certain number of boxes available each day. That will not be the case this year. If you want to grab a monumental box, you better get to the National early. Make plans to grab one as soon as you arrive. Upper Deck does not anticipate they will last even to the weekend.
They generally seem to sell out in the first 2 hours of the day when they were allocated, so I can't even imagine. In addition to receive one 2019 Upper Deck NHL Stanley Cup champion set, you just need to purchase any 5 packs of a 2018-19 NHL Upper Deck hobby product.
That's cool.
Right, any 5 packs. Just make sure you bring them to the booth before you rip them. Now, feel like busting a case of Upper Deck product? Well, then you will want to know about their case breaker promotion. Collectors can open a sealed case purchase from a certified diamond dealer at the show of select products, and then, without waiting in any lines at any time throughout the show, will receive the following from Upper Deck. 8 2019 Upper Deck National Black Packs. 1 2019 Upper Deck Goodwin Champions Uncut Sheet. If you're flying, figure out in advance how you're going to transport that. And 1 Casebreaker raffle ticket, good for a random memorabilia item, premium hobby pack or box, premium trading card, or prominent cuts VIP autograph card. The item selected will be immediately available to the participant. Remember, that's all for one case. Similar to Monumental, these will not be allocated to a certain amount available. Fans can grab them while they're available, so don't wait, as they always sell out. So bring your one case, or two cases, or three cases, we're not counting, of Ice, Okeechee Platinum, Synergy, Goodwin, ooh, Ultimate Collection, ooh, or UDA Supreme Hardcourt, I'm up for that, to the Upper Deck booth, and break the case in the comfort of the Upper Deck Breakers Lounge.
Upper Deck is bringing in the charity Kidority Cards to have a presence in the company's corporate booth this year. Kids should stop by to meet the Kidority Cards crew, who will be handing out free Upper Deck cards and goodies for fans in attendance. Kidority Cards is a charity focused on sharing the hobby with the next generation of collectors. They will be accepting Upper Deck cards at the booth to repackage for kids they work with, and accepting donations to help them with supplies and shipping expenses. Collectors should really consider a donation to this worthwhile cause. And don't miss out on Upper Deck's daily raffles. Each day, Upper Deck will host free raffles to say thank you to fans. Try to arrive at least 15 minutes prior to the draw to get a free ticket where you can score insert cards, signed memorabilia, sealed product, Upper Deck gear, and more.
How fun is this, Rob?
I don't know. I don't know.
Friends, attendees taking photos at the National can make them into their very own digital Upper Deck card without even having to go to the booth.
Wow.
All you have to do is use a custom Snapchat filter that will be available each day of the show. Well, you do have to go to the booth to check it out, but they'll give you the details there on how to access it. In other manufacturer news, Historic Autographs has a show-only release and a reward program in place for this year's show. Dingers and Dunks is, first off, the best named product we've had in the hobby in a good 5 freaking years. It's also a premium buyback product that will include some of the biggest names in modern collecting, with ink as rare as one of one. There will be less than 200 boxes made for this one, and they will include today's stars, Hall of Famers, top rookies, rookie patch autos, sets, parallels, and even one-of-one Federal League art cards. If you know Kevin Hefner, you know he doesn't release a product that doesn't have a ton of greatness in it. The rewards program for historic autographs is simple. Stop by the historic autographs booth, view and reserve one of the 13 cards available. Go purchase the qualifying amount of product on the show floor, bring that product back to the historic autographs booth, and pick up your card. Note, cards will be reserved for 1 hour, so it's a little supermarket shop going on there if you do want to participate in that.
Well, if you're thinking of or have already purchased a VIP ticket for the National, here's some of the goodies you can expect to find in your bag. First, Ultra Pro has provided 2,500 raffle tickets and card gauges in snap tights to all VIP attendees. Plus, in addition to the three autograph guests at the VIP party, VIPs will receive an additional 12 autographs, six of which will be randomly selected from the guests pictured here. And then the other six tickets will be what are called wildcard tickets. A wildcard ticket can be used for any of the VIP guests that is called as a wildcard. This will take place near the end of the autograph guest session, after ticket holders with the guest name on the actual ticket have entered the line. 12 autographs plus three, that's 15 autographs.
That's good math, Rob. I wasn't expecting that. Well, hey, there's something that everybody likes collecting, and that's the VIP sets from the various manufacturers. So let's take a quick look at what you can expect to find. Leafs VIP set consists of cards of Harrison Ford, Stephon Curry, Kyler Murray, and Wander Franco. Upper Deck has a five-card set this year with cards featuring Tiger Woods, Wayne Gretzky, Serena Williams, Ben Simmons, and DeAndre Ayton. Oh, there's a curveball for you. Topps is dishing up Chicago baseball legends in true Topps fashion. Way to stick with that theme. Ernie Banks, Chris Bryant, Ryan Sandberg, and two other guys.
Shut up. Frank Thomas and Carlton Fisk.
I don't know who they play for. And then finally, Panini has a special 10-card set that will be distributed to registered show VIPs. The multi-sport set will be distributed through a coupon inserted into each of the show's VIP packages, so be sure to actually open your package and look at it. Don't just not wait until you get home from the show. The coupon must be presented at the Panini America booth. Featured in this year's VIP set are show-only trading cards of a few names you might recognize: Kyler Murray, Dwayne Haskins, Daniel Jones, Vladimir Guerrero Jr., Fernando Tatis Jr., Eloy Jimenez, Trey Young, Luka Doncic, RJ Barrett, and one mystery card. Oh, I wonder who that could be, that will be unveiled as the show draws closer.
It's obviously Zion, right?
Well, I don't know.
Some other items of note taking place at the National this year. Well, calling all hockey card collectors. And I love that people are doing this stuff outside of show hours to add events. Join Puck Junk, Tree Collectibles, and Slab Stock on Friday, August 2nd from 7 to 10 for a fun night of trading, raffles, prizes, and the chance to just hang out with fellow collectors. The venue will be somewhere at the Hyatt Regency O'Hare across the street from the convention center. So be sure to stop by booth 695 for more information.
Be sure as well to check out the online retailing giants, DA Card World, Steel City Collectibles, and Blowout Cards. They will be offering products at super competitive prices, competing with each other, love it, and will be the place to purchase your Rapper Redemption eligible products, as well as the site for various promos and giveaways all week long. Also, a late addition to the Wax Pack Nation booth, stop by Friday at 1 p.m. for an exclusive signing and meet and greet with Stu Stone, who looks like he'll be making the rounds hot on the heels of Jack of All Trades, the baseball card documentary being picked up by Netflix. Also, Rob, I've got one other thing to add. We mentioned it briefly, but the Ripping Wax Case Break Pavilion it's worth walking through, getting to meet a lot of the breakers that you know. And also, especially if you have kids, most of the breakers put out their base cards for kids to go through and find their favorite teams. So don't think of that as just a place for the people online that can't experience the show. Make sure to stop by, say hi, and check out the action there as well.
Absolutely. All right, so now despite the Nationals starting in less than a week, we have not yet heard any plans from Panini America aside from what's been previously mentioned during this segment. However, if things hold true to form like they usually do, the company will most likely be releasing full details of their plans tomorrow. So look for information about Panini's plans for the following: their Rapper Redemption program, their daily box wars, their customer service related presence, and the regular kids breaks they run at their booth throughout the show aside from the main stage one on Saturday. So that's everything that's happening at the National. I think that's everything, Ivan. Did we forget anything?
You know, we did, Rob. We forgot the fact that there are literally hundreds, maybe even thousands, of regular dealers set up with singles. With
oh, yeah, that boxes, too.
With autographs, with memorabilia, with game programs from the 1950s that you can never see anywhere else. The show floor at the National is just a bunch of fun.
Absolutely. All right, James, I'm going to throw you a curveball after that. Before we dive into this next segment of box breaks, can we go ahead and run the San Diego Comic-Con Part 2 video? Is that too perfect? All right, so San Diego Comic-Con always comes just a weekend or so before the National, and here's some happenings that we're taking place at our friends at Cryptozoic. Check this out, and we'll be back to break Bowman Platinum and Topps Archive Signature Series.
My name is Amanda, and I'm here at Cryptozoic's booth at San Diego Comic-Con, booth number 115. So for trading cards, we have a couple cool things happening. So we still have our Outlander exclusive CZX dual wardrobe autograph card for Laura Donnelly from Outlander. So that's very exciting. We have a couple left, but we're getting really down, and we're going to probably sell out today, Saturday. And we have already sold out of our San Diego exclusive Steven Universe exclusive autograph for Estelle as Garnet. So these went really fast. They were really popular. It contained an autograph and a sketch card, as well as a couple cards from the base set. This one contains the CZX dual the wardrobe autograph card, as well as the new promo card, this one, P8, I believe, and then a couple other CZX promos randomized inside. So these have been really fun. People have been really excited about them. They line up at our booth like first thing in the morning. Like I said, the Steven Universe sold out really fast, and then we luckily still have a couple, but we're running low, and it's about noon. So the demand has been excellent. Everybody's been really excited about them. We're really excited to show off our new CZX line to all of our new fans. So the CZX line hasn't released just yet. For those of you who don't know what CZX is, CZX Outlander will be our very first CZX brand. CZX is going to be a new premium trading card set. So all of the cards are on a really thick cardstock. So these are our promo cards for CZX. So these ones are free. So these ones are for CZX Outlander and for CZX Superheroes and Supervillains. So they're printed on a thick cardstock with gold foil. So every card will have gold foil. For example, here's one of our other trading cards, or promo cards for Bombshell Series 3. So you can kind of see the difference in the cardstock. Yeah, so these have been really exciting. So our CZX will offer unprecedented ratios for autographs and sketch cards and wardrobe cards, dual and triple autographs, autograph wardrobe combos, a lot of really cool, exciting stuff. So it is a higher price, but every single card has value and the ratios and guarantees are absolutely astronomical. So we're really excited to bring this really premium product. So I also want to talk about the superheroes and supervillains, which will be coming out in 2020. So Ezra Miller Flash will be our San Diego Comic-Con exclusive promo. And CZX superheroes and supervillains will be covering the DC Cinematic Universe from Batman Begins all the way up to Shazam. We have like A-list signers like Gal Gadot, Henry Cavill, all sorts of really exciting stuff, Jason Momoa. So just to name a few, we have some like top tier professional sketch card artists, only the best, they're really cool. So that would be CZX superheroes and supervillains. I had mentioned this a little bit briefly, but our after CZX, Outlander will be the DC Bombshells Series 3 trading card. So we're excited to hand out this Batwoman promo at San Diego. We also have the Rick and Morty Season 3 trading cards also coming soon. So this is our San Diego promo for that one as well. And then we also have our most recent release, which was Steven Universe. So this one has been really fun. This is our San Diego exclusive. Let's see, this is P7. So this one actually already released. And we have an exclusive. This one is also a San Diego Convention exclusive promo card as well. You can get this one by buying card packs from us or buying a box or coming in cosplay. There's a lot of fun ways to earn this one. And it is by Mally Flores. All right, and I think that is it for all of our promo cards and trading cards that we have here at San Diego Comic-Con.
Did you see that Freddy Ilmo Krueger at the end there?
So great. Yeah. All right, let's continue on with some live box breaks. 2019 Bowman Platinum Baseball Cards. This is a Walmart exclusive product that delivers two autograph cards in every box with an SRP of $80. This product has actually performed pretty well for us in the past. We'll see if we can continue on with that this year.
Also, keep in mind with this, Rob, four of the year's biggest rookies are short prints.
Wow.
Vladimir Guerrero Jr., Pete Alonso, Fernando Tatis Jr., and Eloy Jimenez are all short prints. That said, they don't appear to be particularly rare, just slightly short printed. And they also share spots on the checklist with other players. So there's 100 cards on the checklist. But there's that. There's 10 additional variations. Now, those 10 additional variations are really tough. So I'll keep an eye out on those, and thank you to Ryan Cracknell at Beckett Media for doing such great reporting.
Little insert action, we went by there. Juan Soto, Platinum Presence, classy looking card.
Looks like Trout, Otani, Bregman, Acuna, Yelich, Yusuei Kikuchi, Juan Soto, Reese Hoskins, Mookie Betts, and Gleyber Torres have them.
Justice Sheffield, renowned rookies, insert. Chance Adams, rookie. Nice, clear, crisp design. Justice Sheffield base. Shiny Jake Lamb. Whatever our autos are, please just don't be Ryan O'Hearn. Nice. Prismatic Prodigies, Hunter Green. Autograph guest at the Topps booth. That'd be a great card to have him sign. Ronald Acuna Jr. Danny Jansen.
Can you show me the Ronald Acuna again real quick? Sorry, I was trying to look up some stuff. I just want to see if it's the variation. With the bat? No, that's the base. Trout, Otani, Bregman.
Joe Adele.
Yelich. Yusuai, Juan Soto, Rhys Hoskins, Mookie Betts.
Eloy Jimenez. Is he a short print, Eloy?
So it's actually, I don't know, they're calling it a variation, but the odds don't seem to be tougher on them.
Got it.
On the four rookies that are variations.
All right, first autograph, Logan Webb. Logan Webb.
Oh, that's funny. I have... Hold that back up to the camera. Is it the same picture or a different picture? I literally have his right here also. Oh, different picture. Different picture. Looks the same, though. Apparently, he does that motion a lot.
We'll go ahead and give that away. Kristen Stewart, renowned rookies. Still, when I see Yasiel Puig in a red uniform, it still throws me off. I don't know why that is. Michael Kopech. Nico Horner.
Ooh.
Keegan Autograph. Thompson. No. Prismatic Prodigies. Nick Solek. Jose Ramirez. Zach Greinke. Griffin Conine. Platinum Presence. Wander Franco.
Hey, there we go. Got a little Wander.
Kevin Newman. Luis Urias. Luis Urias, my bad.
One thing I like to do when I'm searching on eBay for cards, just to get a sense of a set, is to search auctions, highest price, and then scroll down to see what actually has action on it, because obviously there's an auction listed at $2,500 that doesn't have any action on it.
Colby Allard, rookie, renowned rookies.
Very cool. But it gives you a chance to see some pricing on some of the hits from this, see what's popular, and also see some of the 101s that may have been pulled already.
Here's a purple parallel platinum presence of Victor Mesa, numbered to 250. That's cool.
Nice.
Chris Bryant, Steven Duggar.
Good looking Chris Bryant base card. Good job, Tops.
Yeah, it is. It really is. Kind of popped for me as I was going through them. Grant I don't know. Prismatic Prodigies. Victor Robles. Joey Gallo. Yusniel Diaz. Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Joey Votto. Kristen Stewart. So we're pulling the good rookies. Nick Madrigal. Hey, and for you Cub fans, there's a Nico Horner autograph.
Whoa, hey, there we go. That's what I was asking for just a minute ago.
Yeah, it was. Ask and you shall receive.
Keep holding that there for just an... Oh, gosh. It's like trying to take a picture of a monkey. Awesome. Well, hey, Rob, there you go. After years and years, it seems, of Ryan O'Hearn...
Got through a box without one. Nice. Yeah.
With a good prospect auto there.
Yep. And just as we say his name, there he shows up in renowned rookies. Corey Kluber, Cody Bellinger. So parallels are kind of few and far between. Found just one so far. Which, I don't know, gives them a little extra juice, if you ask me. Yeah, that pops, that prismatic prodigies design. Tuki Toussaint, I like saying his name. And we close things out with a base of Ozzy Albies. Pretty nice product. I think that's pretty cool. That's a pretty, you know, you put a hobby type product in retail or as they say, mass market. You include the top rookies, you make a nice design, you include some inserts and parallels and hits, and you really can, you know, turn fans into collectors. And because for so many people, it is their hobby shop. So two winners in that box.
Yep. The Logan Webb and the Nico Horner.
All right.
That's awesome. So again, go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive to enter to win. You'll be able to see the tweets right there that you need to retweet to enter to win. Pretty simple. We like to keep it simple for you.
All right. Last but certainly not least, a low risk, potentially very high rewards, 2019 Topps Archive Signature Active Series, a Signature Series Active Player Edition, one encased buyback autograph card per box. So Active Player Edition means that later this year we will also see a retired player edition. Again, thanks to Suze for hooking us up with some great stuff. All right, here we go. Not bad. How about... Boom! How about a Allen and Ginter one-of-one buyback of Luis Severino autograph jersey.
Wow, that's pretty cool. Bringing in the jersey part.
So the card was originally a one of one Ginter, and they bought it back and packaged it.
Well, it might not have been a one of one from Ginter. Keep in mind.
You think they stamped it for this?
Yeah, they oftentimes do. So it was probably just a relic card from Ginter.
And then they add the auto. Yeah, that makes sense. It's a 101.
Well, yeah, for sure.
Nobody can argue with that.
It'll be numbered to 97 and, you know, 153 and things like that. So, no, it's pretty cool, and especially for any Yankees fan that's watching, that could be a really awesome hit. So, yeah,
that's a good question, James. What do you think comes first, the autograph or the stamp? I would say the foil stamping, probably done at the same time as this one up here, would be my guess. All right, so that wraps up our box break segment for tonight. Stay tuned to find out if you are a winner. Next week, being the week of the National, you can expect a handful of quality new releases, including two of my favorite entertainment properties, period, in the hobby. And we kick this edition off of Hobby Hot in the Shop, rather, with 2019 Leaf Metal Pop Century trading cards. I did a in-depth piece on this that is available on GoGTS.net right now. Some really interesting things to look for in this release. But you're guaranteed four autographed, multi-signed, cut signature, or memorabilia cards. Look for base autos from an absolutely amazing checklist with literally the widest selection of signatures in pop culture history. From Harrison Ford, Daisy Ridley, Al Pacino, Ben Affleck, Matthew Broderick, Gina Davis, and many more. Gina Davis, first-time signer ever. Sci-fi signatures showcasing a robust checklist from classic sci-fi science fiction movies with stars like William Shatner. Heartbreaker signatures, a look at stunning beauties featuring Jennifer Love Hewitt. Vinyl signed signatures, hit makers who have impacted the music industry. Look for dual, triple, and quad autographs, co-stars, or themed combinations that deliver an incredible collectible. And then classic roles. How about iconic roles from entertainment history like Burt the Bandit Reynolds from Smokey and the Bandit? Cut signatures, limited edition cut signature cards are featuring a variety of interesting pop culture personalities, including Lady Gaga, Scarlett Johansson, and many, many more. Pop Century Wardrobe Cards is enhanced this year. There's the least are two, and there are many as eight swatches per card. Check it out, Leaf Metal Pop Century.
Rob, it's National Week, which means that we've got some big baseball cards. That's right, we got 2019 Topps Chrome baseball cards in Hobby and Jumbo coming out. Each box is going to deliver five autograph cards. Sorry, that is one thing. Hobby Jumbo. Each Hobby Jumbo box is going to deliver five autograph cards and 12 base card refractor parallels. This is back with bigger, brighter, better than ever rainbows of colorful chrome parallels with the season's biggest debuting stars with rookie cards in on-card autographs. Some of the hits include one debut gear card per hobby case. Sounds like that's focused on a rookie's debut. There's going to be rookie autograph cards with refractors numbered in 499, purple, blue, blue wave, gold, gold wave, orange refractor, orange wave, which are new and numbered to 25 and hobby only, red refractor parallels, red waves, and super fractor parallels. Ooh, also look for some new 1984 Topps baseball autographs featuring today's best rookie and veteran subjects on the 1984 Topps baseball design, as well as 1999 Topps Chrome baseball autographs, a recreation of the Topps Chrome baseball base design 20th anniversary, which features sequentially numbered and paralleled versions. And I mentioned those debut gear cards as a case hit, showcasing established veterans and retired players on their MLB debut organization, along with a swatch relic from that team. Look for freshman flash autographs, future stars autographs, dual rookie autographs, as well as plenty of inserts and plenty of color. That's Hot in the Shop on the 31st.
When this next product was debuted at the Upper Deck distributor meeting, I was impressed. 2018-19 Upper Deck NHL Chronology Volume 1 is going to deliver three hits, including one autograph card guaranteed, and then two additional autographs or chase cards, plus one base card or 0 degree Celsius card in every box. Chronology Volume 1 is the first release in connection with the NHL Alumni Association and will feature only retired players. Very cool. Look for the famed Canvas Masterpieces cards, a 50-card set continuing the lineage of the famed basketball Chronology Masterpiece painted cards from a decade back, featuring original art from the trading card industry's finest sports artists, including green border and black border parallel versions. collect franchise hero autographs. Unbelievable checklist of approximately 300 signers. Cards feature team-based prefixes, allowing team collectors to build team sets. Duh. Long overdue. Find Letterman patches, including a sprawling checklist of up to 200 different players. Every player featured will have a full nameplate or letter patches to collect. And what's more, 90% of the letter patches are signed, and all of them are serial numbered to 20 or less. Look for between 4 to 6 letter patches per inner on average. An inner case contains 8 boxes. So you do the math. 8 to 12 of them per master. Diamond relics, including auto versions, gold premium parallels, combo cuts, and much more in this tribute to retired hockey greats.
Rob, it wouldn't be a National without a new football product either, would it?
No.
So we're getting 2019 Panini Majestic NFL football cards just in time for the National. Each box is going to feature 2 packs with 4 cards. Four of those cards are going to be autographed. 2 of them are going to be memorabilia cards, plus 1 base and 1 parallel card. This features NFL photography and materials specific to the 2019 NFL rookies. So look for autograph sets such as capstones with 4 swatch on-card autographs, rookie scripted squatches with NFL photography on 40 of the top 2019 NFL rookies, royal signatures with the greatest current and retired NFL players, majestic signature rookies, part of the base set. These will be highly collectible and maximum numbered to 199 with parallels down to 1 of 1. Highly revered, a checklist of top players on hollow board cardstock. Sign me up yesterday. Looks great. Ring bearers, dual signatures, especially great if you're a team collector and your team is represented. Mystic marks with full color photography against a black background. And then majestic rookie materials. Look for oversized memorabilia of the 2019 NFL rookies and other star players, such as Saquon Barkley, like you see there. Stunning on-card autographs from the best current and retired stars the NFL has to offer. Jersey cards of the top stars in the NFL. And hunt for incredible multi-signed cards in this product. It's going to be a fun rip. Can't wait to hold some in hand at the National.
And I can't wait to get our hands on a box of this one. 2019 Topps WWE Undisputed Wrestling cards, baby. 8 autographs, 2 relics in every box, featuring the top WWE men and women's division superstars, legends, and NXT prospects, featuring spectacular designs on premium 48-point cardstock. Undisputed autographs featuring on-card autographs from all the stars you know and love with parallels numbered from 99 down all the way to 101, as well as 101 printing plates. Look for dual autographs numbered to 25 with gold parallels, purple and red from 10 to 1. Triples in the same, triples numbered to 10. Parallels purple number to 5 and reds 101. Tribute cut signatures, classic WWE legends in 101. Autographed kiss and shirt relic book cards featuring an autographed kiss and a jumbo shirt relic swatch from a WWE or NXT women's division superstar and numbered to just 5. Quad autographed book cards, new tag team dual autographed championship book cards, autographed shirt relic cards, superstar roster cards, and new this year, Rob Schmamager portraits featuring a 10-card set illustrated by official WWE artist Rob Schmamager. All that and more in Undisputed.
Rob, we got to have every sport represented, right?
Yep.
So this week I'm excited to say we get Panini Contenders Optic basketball cards. So if you've enjoyed Panini Contenders or Donruss or any of those base sets, well, now we're getting Contenders Optic, which means it's a little higher end. Each box is going to have 1 pack of 6 cards. However, one of those cards is going to be an autograph. 2 are going to be parallels, along with 2 inserts and insert parallels, or insert parallels, I should say. This is the debut in basketball of this combination of the best of both brands. Look for rookie season tickets with vibrant parallels, rare tribute autographs, new insert designs, and much more. Get things like that rookie season ticket gold vinyl. Absolutely exciting. You can also get historic MVPs, historic rookies of the year, class acts inserts, veteran tickets that will feature a plethora of stars and legends and feature plenty of colorful parallels as war. 1998 Contenders Tribute Autographs. These are nice. Extremely rare. Highlight some of the top rookies of 1998, 2003, and 2007 drafts with autographs. And then, of course, up-and-coming Contenders Autographs, signatures from some of the league's best up-and-comers in an exciting autograph set. And, of course, with Optic technology comes lots of color. Look for exciting parallels, exciting inserts, dynamic cards. And, Rob, little national trick. This is one of the ones where there may be a breaker or two where they have some base and some inserts of this, which is a pretty good-sized higher-end product. You may be able to pull some of those base and inserts just by visiting the Ripping Wax Case Break Pavilion at the National. So excited to see this. Hopefully we'll get some of it to come up to the stage to hold in hand. Shiny Contenders Optic basketball cards coming out this week.
And more football coming at you in the form of Immaculate Collegiate, delivering 5 autographed or memorabilia cards plus 1 base or parallel card in every box. Panini says, quote, "This year's Immaculate Collegiate football should be one of our best yet by combining premium patches, legendary autographs, and a strong 2019 NFL draft class." So look for rookie patch autographs, an Immaculate icon. Autographs are also combined with prime memorabilia to create cards with team logo shields, conference bowl, and championship logos. Immaculate signature patches, autographs from today's young stars paired with prime memorabilia in this limited 5-player set. Collegiate helmet logo is always a fan favorite. The helmet team logos are all headlined. And Immaculate Trio is an 8-card set that features star-studded groupings from the same school. Immaculate Jumbo Conference logos featuring oversized swatches of player memorabilia across multiple sets. On-card autographs and jumbo memorabilia cards highlighting the best of the 2019 draft class. Team slogans, quads, and more. Base set's just 35 cards, limited to just 99 copies. This will be broken en masse, guaranteed, in the Ripping Wax Case Break Pavilion in next week's National. Check it out. And that wraps it up for a look at Hot in the Shop, 40th National Sports Collectors Edition. all those products release next Wednesday, 7:31 at the National. Okay. Ivan's got some work to do to pull the winners of tonight's, the hits from tonight's breaks. So we're going to dish up part 3 of 3 from San Diego Comic-Con of Topps talking Star Wars. All right. We'll be back to wrap up prizes, give you one quick note, and send you on your merry way until we meet again, streaming through the National. Watch this.
Hi, everyone. I'm Mark Von Olin from Topps and Star Wars Authentics. Welcome to San Diego Comic-Con. We're here at booth 2913-B in the Star Wars Pavilion. We've got some exciting exclusives at the show, some gifts with purchase, and all sorts of new trading cards from Star Wars coming later this year to talk about. Coming out first is Topps Chrome Legacy. This will be in stores in August, and this is on our Chrome technology. Features 1 hit per mini box. And this will be covering pretty much the prequels and the classic films, which is very exciting. Lots of great autograph signers in here. This is actually where you'll see Ewan McGregor make his debut for Cards for Us, which is super cool. Also included in here is like Harrison Ford, Carrie Fisher, Daisy Ridley, Adam Driver, lots of other awesome signers. Coming a little bit later in August is the Skywalker Saga. So as you know, 2019 is all about closing out the 9-movie compilation of the Skywalker Saga, from Anakin's story to Luke and Leia, all the way to Kylo Ren. We are getting you ready with that, with this product that really focuses in on those stories. This is on the standard trading card tech. And we'll feature signers from across all those different parts of the saga, so the prequel, the classic, and the new trilogy as well. Some of the big exciting news from the show this year is all about Rise of Skywalker, and one of the big dates to look out for is Friday, October 4th. So that is what they're calling Triple Force Friday. There'll be product in store for Rise of Skywalker Episode 9, Jedi Fallen Order, which is the new video game, which looks super cool, and then The Mandalorian, which is the new streaming service, streaming show that'll be on Disney Plus. And it actually launches in November, but you'll see licensed product for all of those properties in stores on October 4th. So great day to go to like your Walmart, your Target, or order product through your distributors like GTS, so you can see what all the new products are going to be. We at Topps have trading cards coming out for Journey to Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker, and that's going to get you ready for that 9th part of the series. It'll have Episode 7 content, Episode 8 content. It'll preview a lot of new images from Episode 9, and it'll include a really comprehensive signing list, such as Daisy Ridley, Adam Driver, Domhnall Gleeson, who's pretty new, Kelly Marie Tran, that'll be where she makes her debut, John Boyega will be in there, Billy Lord, Laura Dern. We've got some exciting signers. Oh, Yonis Otomo plays Chewie, Anthony Daniels, Kenny Baker, lots of great signers from Episode 7 and 8 in that product. So then, coming out at the end of the year to cap off an amazing year on top Star Wars trading card products, we've got two very high-end sets. The first is Star Wars Masterwork. So if you guys are familiar with Star Wars Masterwork, this is one of our high-end sets. It's going to hit your hobby shops in November, so be sure to order from GTS. Take a look at, I think it's on sale right now. The order window, I think, is still open. I'm going to show you some of the autograph cards that we debuted here at the booth. First up is Ewan McGregor as Obi-Wan Kenobi, and this is the first time we've had him sign cards for us. It's very exciting. As you can see on the card, he's got a little inscription for you telling you he's Obi, as if we didn't know, and he gave you a little kiss too. This is the one-of-one gold frame card, so the autograph cards, they're actually slabbed for protection for the show. They won't be slabbed in product though, just to make it clear, but we wanted to make sure they stay safe and then make it into product back to the office in one piece. You can see on the back, this is where it says one-of-one. So that's our gold-framed autograph parallel. And these are hefty cards. I forget the point on this. I think they're 72 point. They're pretty big. We also have silver-framed autographs that are numbered to 5. So this is Hayden Christensen as Anakin Skywalker. And I'm going to flip it to the back so you can see the sequential numbering. There he is right there. So you'll find those for pretty much all the signers. We also have wood grain cards that are numbered to 10. So this is Ian McDiarmid as the Emperor. Actually, in this case, he's Supreme Chancellor Palpatine. Lots of different iterations of the Palpatine. And you can see the wood grain coming through.
Yeah, I do have a few things from you guys.
Yep, numbered to 10. We have canvas cards, which have like a great texture to them. And we do canvas as one of our parallels for the base cards as well. So you don't want to like touch the autograph cards, but the texture on it is really cool. These are numbered to 25. This is Forrest Whitaker from Rogue One, Saw Gerrera. You can see the sequential numbering on the back. And this is an indication of what one of the parallel autographs looks like, but it's the base card technology. So this is the blue parallel number to 99. This is one of our new signers. This is Charlotte Louise. She is in Solo, A Star Wars Story. And one of the reasons we wanted to bring her is to point out that we do have several new people from Solo coming into the product. So Alden Ehrenreich will be in there. Paul Bettany is going to be in there. We've got Ray Park and Sam Witwer. We've got Charlotte, who's making her debut. We have Katie Cartwheel, who's actually the puppeteer behind Rio Durant. So you'll see some of the Solo signers that we didn't have during the first go-round making their debut in Masterwork 2019. We've got a couple of other interesting new signers this year, including Bo-Katan herself, Katie Sachoff. You guys probably know her from some of her other live-action roles, but she does a voice as Bo-Katan, and she's back for Clone Wars, which is very exciting. So she's one of our new signers. So the big product release at the very end of the year is our highest-end product in the top Star Wars trading card portfolio, and that is Stellar Signatures. So what I'm showing you right here is one of the Harrison Ford autographs. It's our one-of-one. I do love the image we picked on this one because it's Return of the Jedi. It's rare that you see him in the brown coat, so very cool. These cards are slab, so you will find them in the slab. We don't have the sticker on it that says Stellar here at the booth, but it will be stickered just like last time. What you're going to get in a case is 36 trading cards that are single signers, and then four duels. So we'll show you some of the duels as well, and we'll be releasing that checklist closer to release, of course. But I'm going to take you through some of the signers we announced today, Harrison Ford being one of them. One of our newer signers for the year, we're very excited to have her on board. This is Kelly Marie Tran as Rose Tico from Star Wars The Last Jedi. So she'll be making her debut actually in the journey to Rise of Skywalker. And then you'll find her in Masterwork and then also Stellar Signatures. We also have Domhnall Gleeson, who is very exciting because he doesn't do signings all that frequently. He's a pretty rare one. You'll find him in all of the Rise of Skywalker related product as well, including Masterwork, Stellar, and then the Rise of Skywalker set that's gonna drop on 12/20. Ahmed Best, Jar Jar Binks himself. So Jar Jar's back and he got a hero's welcome at Star Wars Celebration. So you'll find him in Masterwork and Stellar. And then we've got some awesome dual autographs that are gonna be in Stellar. So these will be randomized within the boxes, but there'll be four hard signed duels. So this one features Ray Park as Maul, so not Darth Maul, but Maul from Solo, as well as Paul Bettany as Dryden Voss. We've also got, now that Ewan McGregor is part of the family, Hayden's been with us for a couple years now. We finally got the elusive dual signed Hayden and Ewan combo, so Master and Apprentice over here. And then this has been the highlight of the convention because it's, you know, it's a Harrison Ford hard-signed dual auto with Adam Driver, so father-son right there. But Harrison signed first, as you can tell, left just enough room for Adam, and you wonder why he got stabbed. So enjoy chasing this one down. This is a one-of-one. So this will be pretty elusive. So that's everything that's coming for Top Star Wars this year. We also have our proper Rise of Skywalker trading card set coming out on 12/20, day and date with the film. And for everyone who is a Star Wars autograph collector, you can also go to StarWarsAuthentics.com and check out our autograph photo collections. We'll do new items for 10/4 for Force Friday, as well as 12/20 for Rise of Skywalker. So thank you everyone for tuning in and visiting with us at San Diego Comic-Con. You can follow at Tops on Facebook, on Twitter, and Instagram, or go to StarWarsAuthentics.com or Tops.com for all the latest information on Top Star Wars and Star Wars Authentics.
All right. Thank you again, James. Some great stuff coming out of San Diego Comic-Con. All right. We've kept you guys a little longer than normal. I think we did pretty good given all the content we had to get through, but let's wrap this puppy up. Ivan, winners, please.
Absolutely. Excited to announce 9 winners from the show tonight. That said, we do need to remind you, if you hear your name called, you have to email us to claim your prize. The email address is right there on the bottom of the screen, gogtslive@gogts.net. It's the name of the show at the website that we keep talking about. Pretty simple, but email us your name, your mailing address, what you won, and your Twitter handle so we can verify. It's pretty much that simple. Rob will get it out before we all leave for the National. If you
get back to us
in a timely manner.
That's it. If I don't have your information by Saturday, let's say noon, I can't guarantee that you will get your stuff shipped before I get back. So
here's the easiest thing. If you're watching right now and you hear your name, email him, gogtslive@gogts.net, to claim your prize. It's that easy. Shouldn't be any tougher than that. That said, we've got some great hits. We're going to start off with Topps Allen and Ginter. How much fun was that, Rob? You got to rip packs and you got to rip cards. Well, let's start off with that rookie autograph. I forget the guy's name because I got so excited with everything.
Patrick Wisdom of the Texas Rangers.
Patrick Wisdom. Well, that rookie autograph is going to Kevin Durr. Oh, it's a mini framed autograph, too. Those are always fun. Yep. Kevin Durr. Congratulations, Kevin. We've also got 2 relics that are going to 1 winner from that product, including a David Bodie. Only a little bit jealous of that, Jeff Moses. But hey, Jeff Moses, if you didn't pick up on that, you are the winner. So, Jeff, you know how to claim. You watch the show regularly. Thanks for tuning in. Next up, we've got the Mookie Betts box topper. I'm going to save that rip card, Rob, just for... Well, okay. You got the rip card. We'll do the rip card. Or you got the box topper? He's got the box topper. Well, the box topper is going to Matt R., whose Twitter handle is Hobo Matt. Matt R. So brand new winner there, Matt. Thank you so much for tuning in and watching. Congratulations. And then the rip card. Well, hey, we're going to meet this guy at the National last week. I saw from the Twitch chat. Go St. Louis Blues, Chris Webb. Congratulations, Chris Webb. So you get the rip card and both of the cards inside of it. How much coolness is that? So that's pretty awesome. Congrats, Chris Webb. Next up, we've got SummerSlam WWE cards. We got a Matt relic of the incredible Carmella. That's going to Sam B. Brand new winner there.
What? Nice. I should mention that this card, I didn't notice. It's numbered to 99, by the way. So that's
Nice. So low numbered. That's going to Sam B. S5B6991 is the Twitter handle. So not an easy one to replicate. So Sam B, make sure that you claim your prize by emailing us. A couple of new, we had a lot of new winners tonight. Must have been the reach for that national. The WWE AJ Styles is also going to a new one. Nate Dog 5075. Congratulations, Nate Dog. Claim your prize before the night is up. All right, moving on to Bowman Platinum. We got Logan Webb, pitcher in the San Francisco Giants organization. That's going to Brady Petrie. Congratulations, Brady. Haven't seen your name in a bit. Glad to see you win something. And then the Nico Horner auto. That's going to Will Blackman, Cubs top prospect right there. One of the top prospects. Will Blackman, congratulations on that win. And then finally, we got the one of one, Luis Severino. Allen and Ginter buyback autograph from Topps Signature Series Archives active players. That is going to Cleveland Fan 1980. Congratulations. Thank you, everybody, for watching. Rob, we didn't have any bonus or surprise giveaways, did we? Anything that I'm missing around here?
Nope.
Anybody want a stapler?
You're good to go. One quick note, if you can't join us in Chicago next week, we will miss you. But you can stay connected with us because all the main stage activities will be streamed live on the national website at nsccshow.com. And there's a special page dedicated to the GoGTS live feed. Find that and watch based on the schedule. Also, if while we were doing the presentation on the preview, you said, what was that? When? Well, good news. All of that information has been put together in a handy guide accumulated over time by James. It's on the GoGTS.website. Just do a search for 2019 National and it will come up for you and you can review everything there. There's tabs for VIP information, manufacturer promotions, case break pavilion, special events, VIP stuff, and a whole lot more. So multiple places to get that information. Again, thanks to Suze at Tops. Look forward to seeing you gents in Chicago next week. We'll have some fun. And we'll dive into the Super Bowl of the hobby. We'll be back the week after the National with a complete recap for you on some hot takes from us. All that and more on the Hobby's web show. You know what to be doing. Until then, always be collecting. For Ivan Lovegren and James Gale behind the scenes, I'm Rob Bertrand. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon. Good night, everybody.